can see that.
What to think in Vataja Prameha, Madhumeha and Yavadhanya. Now particularly about Yavadhanya, which I have mentioned here, is about Kafaja Prameha only. So Vataja Prameha, if is there, then you have to go and check the Charak Samhita, the Sushrut Samhita and Vagbhat Samhita as well, what they have to say about the Samanya Shamana Chikitsa of Vataja Prameha. Then only you can come to the conclusion for Yavadhanya. But in gross, for all types of Prameha, plain Yavadhanya, I never tell them to consume. I always tell them to consume along with wheat particularly, because that's the staple food of India and even in abroad. So that answer I can give you, and it can go along very well with Vataja Prameha and Vataja Prameha Yukta Madhumeha also. Now the second question is by Dr. Mahalakshmi KM. She asked, sir, what is Godhuma and what is Yava? Which of them is wheat? Godhuma is wheat and Yava is basically barley. Then Vaidya Abhishek says, very informative session. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Vaidya Abhishek. And
sir, can I read the questions for you?
No, what about honey? Dhananjay Bairagi. What about honey means I don't get the question itself. So if someone or if the Dr. Dhananjay Bairagi can explain what about honey, that what actually they mean. Then next question is, fermented food with curd are how much helpful in Prameha patients? See, basically this question is by Jaskira Kaur, and thank you for the question. Navanna panam gudavaikrutam cha ke baad mein dahi ye aaya hua hai charak mein. So charak particularly has already mentioned it as the basic nidan or hetu of charak of prameha and as well as madhumeha. So if it is not causing the ajirna as based on matra, kala, vaya, sapekshata, then the ghee can be consumed. But I specially follow the rule of Vagbhat, which gives you the key to consume the dadhi as per Rutu Kal also, and as per along with what you have to consume the dadhi, that is honey, mudgayush and sharkara. So based on that, generally mudgayush is the safest one to go for and can be consumed for all the 12 months or the entire year. If you have to consume honey along with that, then that is also good. In particularly that, the Tikta Shaka reference can be used as an Atidesh Tantra Yukti can be applied over there, that Tikta Rasa Pradhanam Madhu Prakar, that is to name few, is one is neem honey or second one is Tarvi honey, or the reference, other reference of Samshaman, that is Anuloman, Srausan, Virechan, then Haritaki honey. These kind of honeys can also be used along with dadhi. Then that dadhi can be used by the patients. About the fermented foods with curd. Now fermented foods themselves are abhishandi, out of which how to make them. So for example, I'll give you four examples in short very much. Idli, dosa, menduvada and uttapam. These are the four things generally in consumption of everyone in diet. So out of which idli is steamed, dosas are very much thin. So dosas are roasted, fitting in the roasted category. Idlis are steamed, so they are not that sour, because fermented they are, but still they are steamed. So the sourness reduces by the steaming. So idlis and dosa can be consumed. In this, without fermentation also the dosas can be made, where you can replace the black gram or udad with moong, and you can prepare crispy dosas out of it. And I generally tell them टेल माई पेशेंट्स टू कंज्यूम दैट। वैद्य वनीता सुनील चौगुले पाटिल, शी हैज अ क्वेश्चन, प्लीज इलैबोरेट मोर अबाउट यव एज when we सर्च बार्ली दे लुक व्हाइट बट यव इज ब्राउन इन कलर। सी द वराइटीज ऑफ यव आर फ्यू एंड यू कैन यूज एनी ऑफ देम। जनरली ऑफ व्हाइट कलर इज अवेलेबल एवरीवेयर एंड दैट कैन बी यूज ऑल्सो। मॉडर्न साइंस सेज व्हीट कंटेन्स ग्लूटिन विच इज नॉट गुड फॉर डायबिटीज बट इन आवर साइंस यव इज स्टेबल फूड फॉर डीएम। Dr. Mahalakshmi again asked a question, and what modern science has to say about gluten, if we have to understand, then again one lecture we have to take on what is gluten and what it has to do in our body as per Ayurveda. That is not today's topic, so I really cannot comment on that gluten thing, but there are few videos made by me on my Facebook page, on my YouTube channels, which you can refer, and whatever I have explained about wheat and yava combination, if you give it to the patients, then these kind of gluten intolerance and everything can be avoided very easily. And again, castor oil, which I have mentioned, is a boon to that. So I don't think we have to bother about the gluten thing too much, unless and until the rugna of prameha is having upadrav like पक्वाशयगतवात और ग्रहणी प्रदोष। इफ दैट इज देयर देन दैट इज अ विशेष रोग अवस्था एंड दैट हैज टू बी ट्रीटेड विद द विशेष कॉन्सेप्ट। नेक्स्ट इज व्हाट टू थिंक फॉर हनी इन कफज प्रमेह। व्हाट टू थिंक फॉर हनी इन कफज प्रमेह मीन्स चरक हैज ऑलरेडी मेंशनड अबाउट हनी टू बी यूज इन कफज प्रमेह। आई हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन यू द रेफरेंस विद अधिदेश तंत्र युक्ति ऑफ तिक्त रस प्रधान मधु कैन बी यूज। देर आर ऑलमोस्ट मोर देन 5,000 वराइटीज ऑफ हनी ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड। सो फ्रॉम वेर एवर योर पेशेंट इज यू कैन आस्क देम द वराइटीज ऑफ हनी दे गेट एंड आउट ऑफ इट यू हैव टू एज पर बेस्ड ऑन द द्रव्य गुण यू कैन सिलेक्ट द टाइप ऑफ हनी एंड रिकमेंड द पेशेंट टू कंज्यूम इट। नेक्स्ट इज तैल इज वात कफ हर। What is contraindication for oil in prameha? Taila is vata kapha har. Dhananjay Bairagi, you please open the reference which I have given of charak kaphaja prameha. Today I have only have taken kaphaja prameha shaman chikitsa. I haven't taken पित्तज वातज और द्वंद्वज और त्रिदोषज प्रमेह और मधुमेह। आई हैव ओनली स्टिक टू कफज प्रमेह विच इज गेटिंग कन्वर्टेड और विच हैज गॉट कन्वर्टेड इनटू मधुमेह। सो तैल वात कफ हर इज द कॉन्ट्राइंडिकेशन फॉर ऑयल इन प्रमेह। दैट्स व्हाट यू हैव आस्क्ड। यू कैन गिव मी द रेफरेंस देन आई विल बी एबल टू पुट सम लाइट ऑन इट विच कैन बी हेल्पफुल। What is about pressure cooker rice? Again, what I can say is there are varieties, and in this particularly I'll give you an example. If rice is made in the pressure cooker, in particularly in urban areas where people don't have time to even cook the food, if the pressure cooker they are going to use, then I tell them two things. One is not to use the aluminium cooker. I tell them to use the steel cooker. And if the cooker is to be used, then what you can do is to make the rice lighter. If one of these items can be added, then you can do that. One is ginger, second is black pepper, third is cinnamon, fourth is garlic, fifth is tamalpatra. Out of these, one item can be put in that rice and water in the pressure cooker, and along with that the rice can be cooked and that rice can be consumed by those patients. But that depends on particularly what type of rog avastha the patient has. But in gross pressure cooker, if is possible to avoid, then that's a great thing. Sir, mudg means moong dal. Mudg means moong, moong means moong dal and whole grain, out of which, as per the pachan shakti, the digestive capacity of the patient, you can select the whole grain or whole pulse of moong, or you can select the dal. In that also, dal with the chilka and dal without chilka is also an option. If the patients are having other complaints which can be getting trouble into, then without chilka, the dal can be prescribed to them. Next question is Vanita Patil Chogule. She says, please guide us about Shiloncha British, Shiloncha Vritti as in Sushrut Samhita. Now again, this has to take at least one lecture with all the references from Bruhatri, then only I'll be able to tell. The best thing to do for this will be go to Ayurvedic Shabdakosh done or made by Vaidya Veni Madhav Shastri Joshi ji and search for this Shiloncha Vritti word, and they have given an elaborative description about this with the reference of Sushrut Samhita. Beyond that, if you want to learn about all these terms, when I talked about the dictionaries to be referred, in that final wording can be of one reference, that is Vachaspatyam. So one can really, if want to learn something, then Vachaspatyam can be opened, which generally is there available in each and every library of every Ayurvedic college. If not, other sources are also there, and Vachaspatyam is there available in the market also to buy. That's the last word for the meanings of these vyakhyas, and there you can learn about Shiloncha Vritti or these kind of other terms. Can we give Chyavanprash in Prameha? Dr. Ravi Kumar Maurya. Now this is particularly with reference to today's subject, Kafaja Prameha. It is there. And Shaman Chikitsa, if we have to consider, then the answer is yes as well as no, both, because it really depends on the case. See, try and understand, I have not gone into the types of Kafaja Prameha. I have mentioned about the Samanya Chikitsa given to Kafaja Prameha. In detail, when we have to study, we have to go and check the types, 10 types of Kafaja Prameha, like Udakameha, Ikshumeha, Surameha, whatever are the types. Every type we have to take. What is Udakameha as per Samhita? That first we have to understand, and based on that, we have to come to a conclusion of what kind of foods and medicines are to be used. I really want to put emphasis on this. I haven't seen a single Vaidya mentioning anywhere about any of the case presentations stating that I have seen a patient of Prameha or Madhumeha which has a samprapti which started from Prameha type called Udakameha or Ikshumeha or Fenameha, and then it is coming to Madhumeha. Everyone wants to jump on Madhumeha, everyone wants to go on the sugar levels and everything. It is not about the sugar levels, because if we are thinking with the lines of Ayurveda, and if we want to emphasize on these treatment methods by food as well as VR and Aushadhi, the gross effect on the body is going to give you the effect of all the other parameters as well, which includes sugar as well. So if you are very much particular about eating the foods in these particular ways mentioned by Bruhatrayi, there is no doubt that your sugar is going to rise. If it is, then definitely you are doing something wrong, which you have to evaluate and come to a conclusion what that wrong thing you are doing. And that's what we Vaidya are sitting over here for those patients, to tell them what wrong and what is right for them. So treat the disease and the parameters should come or fall into the normalcy. Patients are clinically fit either, patients are laboratorily fit either, or patients are clinically and laboratorily both ways fit. Patients can fall into one of these three categories. We are the people who have to decide, even if the pathological things are not correct and clinically the patient is fit, what has to be actually seen and concentrated on. We are the educators of the patients. So for that, Brihatrayi asks and expects from us to do this elaborative study of each and every Prameha Prakara. That is, all the 20 Prameha Prakaras are to be learned by every Vaidya if he has to be a Chikitsak. In a jokey way, generally it is said that Shateshu Jayate Vaidya Sahasreshu Chikitsaka is the sutra from a reference, but Shateshu Marayate Vaidya Shateshu Sahasreshu Chikitsaka, this should not be the future. That is my point. Don't kill 100 just to be a Vaidya. Don't kill 1000 just to be a Chikitsak. Study all these things as per the Brihatrayi. Charak, Sushrut, Vagbhat is not one of those things which can be used as a pillow to sleep. It is to be opened and you have to follow the journey. You have to pass this journey with the help of these friends, because they are real friends and they have done all these fantastic things without expecting anything from you in return. They are just expecting to learn these things and do the upagrahan of these samhitas in your capacity. This is what I can see. Any other question?
Yes, sir. There are a few questions. One question is from Dr. Rupali Kola. Sir, which fruits, dry fruits, recommended to thin and fat patients?
Again, I will come to the Dravya Guna part only. My patients, out of them, many can eat even dates, black raisins. They can eat almonds, pistachio. Then, few times, apricot is also fine. But particularly, figs are, we have to be very much choosy about it. Dates also we have to be choosy about, and black raisins also. But if all these rules are particularly followed by the patients, and if we Vaidya tell them to follow, if they trust us because they get the result out of what they are doing after we tell them, then definitely my patients can even eat mangoes in the mango season. Yes, not on daily basis, but definitely they can enjoy mangoes till the last breath of their life. So not only dry fruits, even fruits also, you can have or you can consume everything, but matra, kala, vaya, sapeksha, ajirana, this is what kafaja prameha has to be dealt with. That's what Charak emphasized on. Next question.
Next question is, sir, what is your opinion about sprouts in diabetic patients?
Good question. Again, sprouting is the process where any grain or pulse is coming in contact with water and sourness is getting built overnight. So here three things are to be considered. One, atijalapan, the grains which are soaked only, and the grains which are soaked and sprouted. The basic difference is the sourness. And if you want to really concentrate on consuming the pulses or the sprouts particularly, then sourness is the key factor, which is again abhishandhi. So that should never be practiced in routine. Yes, patients can consume it on intermittent basis, but regularly or every day a full bowl of raw sprouted moons is not going to help many patients. Few patients might get help out of it, but that percentage might be around 10 to 15% as per my experience till now.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Next question is, which oil do you suggest? Cooking oil. Will you suggest in diabetic patients?
Before diabetes, I would rather say there is a saying called when we are in Rome, be a Roman. So if you're in Mumbai, be a Mumbaiite. If you're in Delhi, then be a Delhiite. If you're in Punjab, be a Punjabite. Basically, wherever you are, based on the desh, you have to first select the oil. Then don't stick to one oil. You can choose 2-3 oils and then you can consume. Grossly for all, if I have to say, then I would rather recommend oil made out of groundnut, oil made out of maybe till, but that too depends on prameha type, kaphaja, vataja, pittaja, dvandvaja, sannipataja, whatever is the type, depends on that. We have to open the samhita again, we have to go to the oil section, we have to check which kind of oil is better for which kind of conditions, and as per the dravyagun we can select that. But grossly I tell my patients to consume hot oils in the winter season and cold oils or comparatively less hot oils in the summer season or rainy season. So particularly if a person named Gupta Singh coming from UP and staying in Mumbai, so I ask them first whether you eat mustard oil or not, and they say yes, then I tell them to stop because now you are not in UP, you are in Mumbai. So mustard oil is not going to help you in Mumbai. That's what I generally do. If they go to village, they can consume that thing. But in Mumbai, frequent use of mustard oil is not good. That's what I generally recommend. Next question.
Yeah. So this is the last question now. Importance of ragi in diabetes patients.
Okay. Ragi is nachni. Nachni is nowadays last 5-7 years, 8 years maybe, herbal industry, ragi is making boom, and the iron supplementation and whatnot is there told by many that consumption of ragi has gone too high. As per Ayurveda, ragi is one of those nikrushta dhanya which gives you the mutral effect. So if you are treating a pramehi rugna, should you use ragi or not? That is one basic question. The answer is no, but yes, if you want to use ragi, then those few references are there in Sushruta as well or Charak as well, where mutra karma or mutra pravrutti is getting hampered somewhere, then you can use things like ragi for time being to correct it, or mutra krutra kind of a thing in upadrava which is coming. If that is the case, then you can use ragi. Ragi is not a thing which has to be consumed regularly. It can be consumed once in fortnight, once in a week, depending on the requirement you have to fulfill.
Yes, questions? Sir. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sir, you got the last question. Thank you so much, sir.
Yeah. Thank you very much again.